honestly, bro, like, and he just said some shit on this last album. Y'all know, like, I ain't never said nothing. Mm-hmm. Never. I'm a real nigga. Like, I take all your secrets to the grave, my nigga. Even though we ain't rocking, like, that's what I do. Like, I ain't just bash no nigga, none of that. But it was just a lot of fucked up shit. I would rather cross me in the streets, because we can handle that a different way. But how we go from doing what we did over on this side, and we get over here with this shit ain't even real, bro. This shit is the music business. Like this, you know, it ain't. That's when you really supposed to hold it down. You know what I mean? But to get over here and for the change up, that shit I don't understand. I couldn't understand it. Cause if you a real nigga, you don't understand like how you doing this. I didn't do nothing. You know what I mean? It was some shit he had done, was saying some shit to my stole some money or some shit. I'm like, bro, like, how could I steal some money? All your money goes straight to the accountant. Every Monday, they cut me a check for my 20%. Mm. You feel what I'm saying? Mm. It was just a lot of bullshit that he was putting in the mix that I didn't like. I wanted to say something, but I'm like, you know what? I don't got to do that.
How did it get to the point where you felt like, because there was a court case. Like, how did it get to that point? Where it's like, we got to go to court about this.
The court case came, well, this is where the problem come in. We had a label, right? We had a label deal with Def Jam. Mm-hmm. They gave us $3 million. Wasn't no problem with that. That was split. The problem came in when it was time to renegotiate with his project. We had the same lawyer, Donald Woodard. Which I advise, any artist do not have the same lawyer as the person that you signed to. People do it, but this my nigga. We good, you feel what I'm saying? I ain't gotta worry about nothing. So, but what happened was, they had sent a letter of direction to the label and diverting money from the company was going directly to him. The first check we got, it came to me. I went to the lawyer office, got the check.
And basically, just not to cut you off, but for those that don't know, a letter of direction is a legal piece of paper basically stating
where
the disbursement of funds is supposed to go.
Okay. So, with that said, first, the money come to us together. So, I get the check, go to the bank. He on the road. I'm like, look, bro, I got the check. I'm like, I'm going to just hold it till you get back. He's like, nah, just deposit it. So, I deposit the money to our company account. He was like, well, we'll just bust it down when we get back out the road. Cool. So I go check the company account one day. The money been moved. I'm like, what the fuck? So he moved the money from the company account. Like, your brother money bill. He's like, yeah, don't worry about it. I'll take care when I get back. Okay, then my nigga, I ain't tripping over like nigga. You know, that money ain't shit. So cool. So one thing that get to another. We working. I ain't even thought about it no more. We on the road, we in a whole nother country, we coming back. But then we go back in, it's time to renegotiate. Because what happened was every album we renegotiate because we was always selling more records. Mm-hmm. So this time around, the check didn't come.
At all.
So then I was like, hold the fuck up. So I asked Donald. Donald was like, well, you need to talk to Jeezy. So then I talked to him. Then he tell me, like, you know, he don't know what's going on. So I'm like, all right, cool. So I see what's going on now. So what I did was, this is back in 2011, I got my own attorney. Mm-hmm. Which, no, okay, who you doing business with? Everybody should have their own attorney. Mm-hmm. Because ain't nobody gonna take care of your business like your attorney. So once I get my attorney, she get all the docs, we get all the docs from Def Jam, and that's when we find out the letter of direction. So my attorney called his, we pulled it, got together, sit down. And before this, just to let y'all know, before even the soup thing came along, just think about this, had went on for about a year. Nobody even know. I ain't say nothing. He didn't say nothing. We were supposed to sit down. We went and met. It's a spot right over there in Buckhead. It used to be, like right once you get off Lennox Road, it's like a little Asian sushi spot right there. They close it down now. You know what I'm talking about?
Blue Sun.
Yeah, they close the shit down. Yeah. We met, me and Jeezy met, went over there to talk. He was like, bro, we're going to fix this shit. I got you. Don't worry about it. The next day, my nigga, Don't you know I called this nigga? Nigga did not answer the phone. So I'm like, what the fuck? So I called my lawyer. Because we put all get in one room and figure that shit out.
Sort it
out. Some money, you know what I mean?
Right.
Figure it out. So he stopped answering my phone call.
You can't think of nothing. Hold on, I ain't cutting y'all. You can't think of nothing you did to this.
Bro, I don't owe this man a dime.
I'm just saying it could be anything that look over shit that you could have put him in a position that he don't even know how to explain. Like, you think y'all can ever have a real conversation? Like a real conversation, like
now?
Because it's like to me, now.
I mean, now, yeah, I do. I mean, back then, you know, I'm young, I'm bullheaded, I wasn't trying to hear that shit. You know what I'm saying? Now, yeah, definitely. Because like at the end of the day,
that shit ain't worth it.
This man is the godfather of my son.
Yeah.
Like, all this shit happened around the same time. He haven't seen my son in years. Like, I know his son called me uncle. Like, I done slept in this man's grandma's house. He done slept at my auntie's house. This shit go deep. It wasn't just like we were just friends, bro. This was...
Brothers.
We was brothers. Exactly. You feel what I'm saying? This wasn't that, bro. Like, this man that left $700,000-$800,000 with me for months. He come back, that shit still there. I got the money. You feel what I'm saying? I got everything, matter of fact. You feel what I'm saying? I just didn't understand it. And at the end of the day, I still don't understand it. But